at the cafe for a bite and couldn't help but overhear this guy. He just pulled up in a U-Haul truck. Tell Becky how pumped he was about moving here for his new job and what a cool little spot it was. Kinda made me jealous and made me mad. Wish I could see this place like that. Yeah, wish I was new.
Hey everybody, Glenn here. This is a video I'm going to do. I gave away one of my Windows phones. I have two. I have one for myself, one for my wife. We're getting new Windows Phone 8s when they come out. And it's supposed to be out sometime this month. And I have a good friend of mine that's just found out he works for Verizon, and he said he's a Verizon tech for Verizon Wireless. And so I'm going to hopefully be able to get a two-day window to know when they're coming out. He said that they usually don't know until 2 days after it's been announced. So I'm going to find out from him exactly. I'm looking to get the Nokia Lumia 920. And they also make the Nokia Lumia 820. But I want the 920 because it has wireless charging built in. Whereas the 820, you have to buy a separate cover for the back, change the cover on the back of the phone to make it wireless charging. So I want the wireless charging built in. The Nokia Lumia 820 has got a SD card slot, but the 920 doesn't. The 920 has 32 gigabytes of storage in it. I was not happy over that. I don't know why they didn't put an SD card slot in it. I would like to have seen that better. But anyway, so that's what I'm after for a phone. Okay, so this is for a good friend of mine, Cindy. She's the one that actually got the phone, because what I did was, I posted it yesterday that I was going to be giving away one of my phones, and didn't take a lot of people to respond, and the first one that responded was just saying that was very sweet of me to do that. It was a friend of mine named Pam, and Pam said nope. Cindy it is, so Cindy, this is for you. The whole world's going to see this video. I'm putting this on YouTube, so, and then I'll share it over on Facebook. This is all my friends on Facebook, and I gave the phone away, and it's a nice working phone. I know which one you're going to get, Cindy. So the one you're getting, we bought back in February of this year. I gave it to my wife for her birthday, so that's the phone that'll be completely wiped. I do have a second one, this is my phone right here. As you can see, this is the HTC Trophy from Verizon. It's a Windows phone, now 7.8. When I first got it, it was 7.0. The minute I connected it to the software, the Zune software, it did an update, and it went to 7.5. So I got a phone at the right time. Got it when it was 7.5. That was the newest, latest operating system. So I'm not going in depth on this phone because I have a lot of time here, and I want Cindy to really see what this phone, how it works and what you can do with it. And I do have the book to this phone as well as the box from Verizon. I always save my boxes for warranty purposes and whatnot. And God, I have an attic full of boxes with all the computer parts because I am a computer builder, repairer, as well as country music star, or working on it anyways. I have one CD that I released last year, and I'm working on doing a whole album. I got to record 10 songs, I have to write 10 songs, then I'll be recording them at RCA Studio B, which is going to be interesting. I can't wait for that. I haven't had the time to sit down and start writing because it's been so crazy in my life with my stepson living in the house with us. It makes it hard, so, he's a disabled child, and we have a fun time with him, but I will get around to it, and I will get it done. They're giving me lots of time, so I don't have to worry about it, but I'm going to, in the meantime, I've already talked to them, and I'm gonna record another single, and gonna have that out there. So we'll see how that one goes. The first one I did was Friends in Low Places. I actually got permission from Garth Brooks to record the song, which was amazing. I got it not directly from him. He did give the okay, but it came from his publicist, his management. They asked him, and he said yes, that it was okay. Even though he had a monster hit with it, he let me record it. So it's really cool. So now the next song that I'm thinking about recording, and I haven't decided yet, but I'm thinking about it, is I am going to have to get permission from the artist again, of course. I am looking to do George Jones, a song by George Jones. He Stopped Loving Her Today. That's the next one that I think I'm going to record. They've told me I've got to go ahead to go ahead and do it if I want to, and it's up to me. I got to pick the song. And if I can make it through that song without crying, and it's going to be hard because that's a really sad song. I know George Jones said he had the same problem recording it. Could not get through it without crying. It was really hard. But anyways, so that's where I'm at. But let me get into the phone here. All right, this is the HTC trophy, like I said. As you can see, right here in the back, there's the camera lens. And there was the flash, the LED flash. As you can see, it says HTC on the back. And if you look right here, right on the top of the phone, it's hard to see, but there's a notch right here where you put your fingernail in behind it, and if you pry it, you can get the cover off the back. Here's your battery right here. The battery does come out, so you can replace it. I've never had to replace it yet. So that's the inside of the phone. It does have a SIM card, for storing all your contacts on. Right here, if you look right here, there is the charging port, USB connection. It's a micro USB port, and I do have a cable that comes with the phone, so you'll be able to hook it to your computer. Now, Cindy, I do want to tell you that when you get this phone, you don't have to subscribe to it, but you're going to have to go download the Zune software, and I will give you a disc with the latest software on it, so when you get it, all you have to do is put the disc into your drive and go through the install process. And you'll also need to create a Windows Live ID. Whether if it's a Hotmail or a Live.com, it does not matter. Just go to WindowsLive.com and look for the sign-in area where you want to create. You want to create, because I know you have AOL, unless you change it. Sure, you're still using AOL. I don't know why, it's a virus, but I can't tell you AOL users about this software being a virus. You guys won't listen, so I won't get into that. Sorry, Cindy. But anyways, you'll need to go create a Windows Live ID to use with this phone, because this has a lot of features that uses Windows Live. So go create a Windows, either a Hotmail account or Windows Live. It'll give you a list. There's a drop-down menu when you get into create it, and it'll ask you, which one you want to create it under, whether if it's a Hotmail or a Live.com. There is also MSN, but MSN is a premium account. You have to pay for it. I have it. I originally got it through Verizon when I first took DSL. They were offering the MSN premium as a free download, and I didn't have to pay for it. Normally it's $9.99 a month to have it, and you can have up to 10 email accounts on that service. It's really nice. I love it. I will never get rid of it. I still have it. Verizon made us pay for it starting beginning of the year. But it wasn't bad, because when I called them, I thought the guy told me $9.99 a month. He said it was $9.99 for a subscription with one-time tech support. Or for $59.95, you could get unlimited. I'm like, wait a minute, $60 a month? I'm really out of their mind. I said, no, I'm going to take the $9.99. I thought it was a month. So I called the number back that they had provided us. They sent me a card in the mail. So I called the number back, and I found out in turn it was $9.99 for the year. So that was fantastic. I got a good price on that. Instead of paying per month, I pay by the year. Unlike my ex, they used to live here at the house. She has MSN Premium, and she pays the $9.99 a month. So that's fine. She still has her same address, and she's still using the MSN Premium. And she loves having the butterfly. You click on the butterfly to go online, and it works really well. And that's also Windows Live, by the way. It's called MSN, but it's all Windows Live. So okay, back to what I was getting at here. Okay, so you have to have a Windows Live account for this phone for several reasons, and I'll get into that a little further into the video. I've got a skinet on my phone, if you can see right here. This is all it would fit. I'm a NASCAR fan. I've been watching stock car racing since I was 6 years old. And I'm now 51, so you do the math. 1966 was my first year watching racing. Been watching it ever since. My real first driver ever was A.J. Foyt. Oh, man, did I love to watch him race. Oh, boy, he was awesome. And I remember one of the cars he had was a 69 Ford Talladega. Oh, my God, I used to love watching that car go around the track. It was all white with number 11 on the doors. Oh, man, I'm telling you. So well, now my newest, latest driver is Matt Kenseth, the number 17, soon to be the number 20 for Home Depot. So I tried to do a Matt Kenseth skinet, and you can see a little bit of his car over here on the side. But anyways, we'll get into that. You can get skins for these phones. I also do a show on YouTube. A NASCAR show is called Around the Corner, and I'll show you this. I do have neoprene covers for this phone, so Cindy, I will give you a couple of covers to go with this phone that are brand new, never been used. But this is the one that's on my phone right now, and I'll show you the cover. Let me move the phone out of the way. This is my neoprene cover right here. The phone slips down into here, and as you can see, it's got an opening right here for the speaker system and the camera and flash to come through on the back side. There's my NASCAR. There's Matt Kenseth's car, and that is my show Around the Corner. So if you're in NASCAR and you want to watch a show, we do upload them. We've been trying to do them once a week, but we've been so busy past couple of months we haven't been able to get around to doing. We got to do another one because Matt's going to be changing teams. He's going over to Joe Gibbs Racing. So he's going to be racing the number 20 Home Depot, the one that Joey Logano's in right now. It's going to be Matt Kenseth starting the 2013 season. So anyway, so that's the skin that I put on the back of that instead of on the phone because I have the cover on. I wouldn't be able to see it. So, all right, so this is the front of the phone. Right up here on the top, you'll see right here, a little hard to see, but there's a button right there. That's what actually turns the screen on. Right now the screen is in what's called lock mode, and the screen is off. It automatically shuts itself off when you're not doing anything with it. All right, I'm going to turn the phone on. I'll show you the lock screen. Okay, here's the phone. I just turned the screen on. Okay, now I put this picture on myself. That's my wife with a really good-looking hair that people like and a nice ponytail and stuff. But anyways, all right, see, it shows the date right here. I mean, it shows the time and the date. And if you look right down here, you'll see all these little, it shows I've got emails, probably text messages are showing there as well. So that's nice. You don't even have to turn on the phone to see if you've got emails in there. You can just do that. All right, and then up here it shows your wireless signal. If you look up here, you can see your wireless signal, your battery power and all that to show how much you've got. And it also shows it's a 3G phone from Verizon. Okay, so now, to just get this up out of the way, all you do is take your finger, swipe up the screen, and here you go. Okay, now here's where I want to get into some things. These right here on this Windows phone, is known as a live tile. See how those tiles are changing constantly? The pictures are changing? Okay, this up here is my weather app from HTC. HTC has, I don't know, maybe a half a dozen or so apps, maybe a little more, that's actually HTC developed the apps for this phone, and that's my weather app. And if you can see, it shows the actual temperature outside, and it's shown that it is cloudy, because it is cloudy here, it's been raining. And if you want to see more of the weather, just click that, and it takes you into the actual, now it shows the time, as well as right here below it, it shows the temperature. And it's showing me other cities that I have in here, like I have Boston, I have Helena, Montana, and Los Angeles, California. And if you see the clouds are moving, this is all part to do with the app and the live tiles. And if you want to see the extended forecast, just tap right here where the time is. And now it takes you to showing the exact temperature right now, showing 59 degrees. And as you can see, it's, you know, showing that it's cloudy. And you can see down here 3 days in advance. So you can see the weather for the next 3 days. So it's pretty nice. So that's the HTC weather app. Now, like I said, these are known as live tiles. Now, these tiles that you see right here, there's six of them right here basically on the screen. These are known as my people's tiles. These are my contacts that are in my phone that I brought out to the main screen. This is my start screen is what this is called. And I will show you how to do this a little further in. Let me show you something a little bit about these tiles before I do that. Okay, this one here is my wife. You can see that's the one with the picture of a ponytail. That's the picture that's on here for a profile pic. This is myself right here. This is my brother with a picture of Saturn. My friend Pam, good friend of mine that I grew up with when I was a kid, Alan. And this is a good friend of mine that's in the NASCAR along with me that's a Matt Kenseth fan. This is my friend Brenda. Let me explain something about these apps. Now see, right here, see how my wife's out saying new message? That's telling me that she has sent me a text message. And if I want to see what she sent me for a message, now I do, like, click the tile. I go into the inside. Now look at right here. See right here? You can see the messages that have appeared. Okay, and it says, hey, sweetie, 2 hours, 2 hours left. So that's it. If I want to actually go to the actual message, and these are older ones, that's yesterday. It shows this week. I can scroll up through these and look at other previous messages from the past. Phone calls, see like right here, it shows one call. That means that she called me on the phone, and it was a missed call. Right here again, no one call. Okay, so see, and now if I want to look at the actual message, now this is all under her tile, mind you. Okay, I can click this message here. Now it's going to take me to the messaging tile. And now here is the messages, and she's got another message here that she sent me. So I'm not going to get into that, but see, here's all the messages that she sends me all right here. I can scroll down, scroll back up, and go through all the messages that she sends me. Okay, I'm going to go back to her tile. Now, that's on the history. That's the history that came up because she had sent me a text message, and it was there waiting for me to look. Now, if you see right here at the top of the screen, it says profile. If I go over to profile, now this is what you normally can do. If nobody sent you a message or a phone call or anything like that, this is the screen you normally come into. As you can see, there's her profile picture. Call mobile, text, call home. Okay. Now I don't have it in here. I gotta add it back in. But when you get this phone, you are going to set it up with your email address and all that stuff. And I'll get to that a little further down. You are also going to, there's a really nice Facebook app for this phone. When you put Facebook in, when you use your Windows Live, Cindy, I would suggest to you to go over to Facebook and change your email address to your Windows Live account, because if you do that, all your friends on Facebook will appear in this phone under your contacts where you have all your phone numbers stored. It'll store your Facebook contacts. And if you scroll down, I'll show you another one. I'll show you another tile here. I'll show you that now. But if you see, look right here, it says call mobile, text, call home, send email, map home address. I'll go to a different one and I'll show you what you can do. I'll go to my friend Alan, okay? Let me come to Alan, okay? Same thing now. See, this is the profile because he hasn't sent me anything today. It says call mobile, text, and chat because you can chat directly from this phone with people on Facebook. So, if, Cindy, if you're out shopping or doing whatever you're doing and you're not home, if I hit you up on the chat on Facebook, it'll come on this phone and you can chat with the phone as well as you can do a voice-to-text chat. So you don't have to actually type with your fingers. You can tell the phone what to say and you can send it right back to the person. Okay, now that's what I was talking about. See right here where it says write on wall? If I want to write on Alan's wall, I could just bring up the screen and I could write on Alan's wall. It goes right on his timeline. On here they call it wall because they haven't changed the phones over the timeline, which is fine. And you can send an email. All that stuff is right here. And now, of course, see now it's listing his significant other as well as company that he works for. Map home address. I want to show you this. This is really cool. If you map home address, actually, you know what? Let me come out of this. Let me go to a different tile because I don't think Alan would mind, but alright. I'll use myself. I don't care. I can use my wife's. Doesn't matter. Let me open my side up. Okay, now this is the me tile. Now, this me tile is great because this is where I can see I can post a message, I can check in, or I can set chat status. If I want to post a message to Facebook, I can do it right from here. If I click post a message, okay, let me just throw my glasses on real quick here. Let me just see if I can see good enough to do this, okay? I'm going to post a message. Okay, I'll do it this way. I'll put, hey, okay, just making, making a video. Ugh. Okay. A little hard. My eyes are a little, I have problems with my eyes right now, and I'm trying to get them straightened out. So it's a little harder to see, but I'll get it. Making a video for my, what do I got here? Okay. I have to specify who this is for because I have more than one friend named Cindy on Facebook, so, for the HTC trophy. Oops. She is getting from me. Okay. Getting from me. Okay, now watch this. Okay. Now, if you look right here, I don't know if you can really see it, but look at this. It shows Windows Live, Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. Now, when I send this, which I'm going to do right now, I'm going to click the button to send it. Now, look at that. Now, if you go on Facebook and look, Cindy, go to my timeline, and you will find this message that I posted. I don't know if you're on any other social networking sites, but I'm on Windows Live. You'll find me on there when you create a Windows Live account. And I will go ahead and I will add you as a contact and friend on Windows Live. I just posted that message with a click of one button, and I sent it to Windows Live, Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn all at the same time at once. That's it. One time. I just posted right here. This is called the me tile. If you look right up here, see what it says me? Well, that's because it's my tile. So if I want to, instead of going on to Facebook and waiting for Facebook to open, I just click on the me tile. I'm already in, right? I click post a message. Right there, it pops up. I type my message like I just did. And then this button down here is the button that sends it. I click send, it's gone. Off to Facebook it goes. Off to Windows Live, Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. It's all on those services right now, all at once. You will not find another phone like this. Windows Live is the only one that offers this feature. And I can do it right from my computer as well. I can do the very same thing. I can send it to those accounts. So you're going to love this phone. This is really nice. Now, I was trying to show you something. Let me go into my wife's because I can't do it from my me tile. All right. Now, I told you before. See this is map home address? Okay. Let me click this. This is going to bring up the Bing Maps. All right. See the Bing Maps? And now you see a little spot where it's highlighted, and it's got like a little flag above it, and it shows my address. Okay, now watch what I do. This is what's called as pinching. I don't know if you've ever done this before, but it's really easy. You put two fingers on the screen, and you hold them together, and see if you pinch them apart. Now, see how the screen's starting to move and zoom in? Now, watch this. Now, this is showing our home address. Now, I'm just going to keep pinching the screen out and out and watch. Now, it shows, it's, you know, you see it's starting to enlarge on the map. Watch what happens when I get in further. This is really awesome. Look at this. Now, I pinched in all the way. And if you look at this house, wait a minute, is that the right one? No, that's my neighbor. You really can't see my house because of the color of it, but it's right in here. Actually, well, it shows the phone right here, so that might be my house right there. Yeah, that's my house right there, where it's showing the location. It's showing it right there. So look at this. It brings you to an actual, not a street view, but an aerial view that comes down pretty close. I would say it's probably down to within probably 30 yards of the structure. And this is my neighborhood all around. So look at that. And you've also got buttons down here. If you hit, see those three little dots right here? If you click those, now look at this. You've got search results, you've got clear map, you can show traffic, you can show favorite places. If you mark something as a favorite place, you can mark it. It's just really awesome. It's got settings as well. You can go into your settings for the maps. But look at that. It's, you know, you can search. This is just an unbelievable phone. You know, all you people that see these Apple and Android phones, right? Especially Apple. You guys think that these Apple phones are like, because everyone's got one, you think it's the greatest. Well, you know what? I'm not trying to be mean or anything, but in my opinion, those Apple phones are not the greatest phone on the market. This Microsoft has got the best phone right here. It started with Windows Phone 7, and they just didn't market it well enough that people caught on to it and actually tried one. If you go onto YouTube and go punch in smoked by a Windows phone, go watch some of those videos, and you will be shocked to see how fast this phone is compared to a Windows or a Droid phone. It'll beat any phone on the market, whether posting a picture or posting a status on the, not just one of your social networks, but all of your social networks. It is unbelievable. You can move the map around. I mean, I can keep going. I can go all the way to your house if I wanted to, Cindy. Just scrolling the map around. It's unbelievable, isn't it? So, I'm telling you, this, and right now, the iPhone 5, they're having problems because people aren't happy with the, they changed the power cord that plugs in. It does not work with your older existing Apple products, you know, your iPods, your iPads, and your iPhones. It's only strictly for the iPhone 5, and that is it. So, I know people aren't happy over that. They're having problems with their maps on there. Their maps aren't working right. We all know Google has really the best maps, but Bing's probably outdone them. If they haven't yet, they're real close. Bing is getting really good with all this stuff. Microsoft's done a really good job with Bing. So that's how you can map someone's address, and that's in every, if I show you, when you put in someone, when you type in someone's address, or if it automatically shows up because it picks it up from Facebook, if it's on Facebook, like I'll go in and see. All right, I'm going to go to my friend Brenda and see what's here. Okay, I don't have her address in here, so that's not there. But see, if I go to, and somebody that does have an address, like my brother, they'll see, I can come into him and map home address. There it is. It's going to show you the address where he's at. Unbelievable. So those are your contact tiles. You can put anybody as a contact out on the front of this phone on the start screen. So it's really an unbelievable phone. I just love this phone. There's over 100,000 plus apps now for the Windows. And in the recent past few weeks, around the beginning of September, Microsoft came out with a big announcing their phones. It came out right after Apple announced the iPhone 5. And what they've done is they've changed their code system between what the phone uses and what their computer uses. So when somebody writes an app for the phone or for the new Windows 8 that's coming out on October 26th, they've got the codes so they're identical, so that, or real, well, not identical, but real close. They've made it so that when a person writes an app for a phone, they can easily change that app over to put it in the marketplace to work on the computer as well, and vice versa. If somebody writes an app for a computer, they can also just change a few things in the app and put it over onto the Windows marketplace for Windows Phone 8. And yes, the apps that you download for this phone will also work on a Windows Phone 8. So they've really done a nice job with this. I've got a lot of apps in here. I've got, this is really cool. I like this one. Cindy, this is the one you got to get. If you ever need a flashlight, you know, it looks like a real flashlight. As you can see, it's on right now, lighting up my hand. And it's got three different settings. If I tap this, right on here where the actual, like you'd see on an actual flashlight, just tap that and watch. See? Oops. Okay, hold on. Let me back up. I hit my camera button by accident. I don't want to do that. Okay. Now if I hit it, see? Now it's getting brighter. I shut it off. That's low, medium, and then high. So look at that. It's really cool. So you got a flashlight app in here. So there's tons of apps. I got my bank app in here. Now this one right here with the telephone handset that it shows, this is where you go to look at missed calls. It'll show you if there's any calls on the front of that, because like I said, it's a live tile. So right here it'll show missed calls. And you go into this. Now see, here's all my contacts. These are people that have called me in the past. They all show up here. And if you want to call them back, just click it. And see, it takes you right to their tile. Call mobile, right on wall, the phone number, home phone there. You can choose what you want to do to contact them. It's really nice. Now see these tiles, little buttons down the bottom. All right. Always when you click this, the three little white buttons that are, the little dots that are there, this brings up to show you what this is. And if you look right here, it tells you what these are. And like there's voicemail. Okay, that's keypad. And that's people. And that's search. So now, if you want to bring up your keypad to dial out, you click the one that says keypad. Now here's your keypad. Look at how nice and big the numbers are. It's really awesome. And you can click save if you want to save the number, and you can save that number and make that a contact. Now if you go to the one that says people, now watch this. This brings me up into my people section, and you can scroll left if you want, what's new, tell me what's going on new with all my friends. These are recent people that have had contact with, whether if it's on Facebook or a text message or a phone call. And then it's back to all. Now, If you want to find someone, you want to contact a particular person, whether if it's a phone call, a text message, email them, or you want to hit them up on Facebook, you can do it this way, and you can scroll down through alphabetically. Or if you want to get to somebody that's way down the bottom and you don't want to scroll all the way, don't waste your time scrolling down. Do this. See the number? It's got like a number. I don't know if you can see it. It's not showing right now. It's got a number pad right here. Just click the number. Now look at this. It brings up A through Z. And if you want to find somebody, okay, Cindy, I'm going to look for you. Guess what? Okay, it brings me right down to C. Now I scroll down and keep going until I find who I'm looking for. I went a little too far. I didn't go far enough yet. Okay. I'm at H. Oh, here you are. See? Now I just found you right there, Cindy Pinnell. And there you go. Now I got you right here. And I go into yours. I can either chat with you right on your wall, send an email. It shows your birthday, and it shows your significant other. Hi, Jerry. I know you'll be watching this as well. You'll be excited for Cindy to get this phone. I don't know which one he's going to use. I'm sure it's going to be Cindy. But then Jerry's going to be jealous because he's going to want one. So Cindy, you better be prepared to get Jerry one of these phones. If you guys are eligible for an upgrade, you're going to want to get him one because he'll want one just like you. These are still available right now. And you'll also see ones that are recertified. You can grab one of those. They're still good. I've had recertified phones before. They're fine. So see, you can get right to anybody you want right by clicking the number thing at the top. So that's really nice. That's the known as the people's tab down here at the bottom. So if I go back, see that's known right there. That's the people's tab. And then next to it, you have the search tab. So if you want to search, and then you can delete all. You can delete what's here. If you want to wipe out the recent calls list, you can. And you've got call settings. You can go into the call settings where it sets up. You can, you know, set your preferences. So it's a really nice phone. Okay, you've also got, oh, Cindy, when you set up a Windows Live account, you'll have a Windows Live calendar you can use. Well, that's right here on the phone as well. Here's my Windows Live calendar. Whether you put on this calendar, whether it be on the computer or on the phone, if you've got a doctor's appointment or an appointment that you need to remember, or you're trying to remind yourself, gee, tomorrow I want to go shopping at a certain time, and you got to put it in the calendar, whether you put on this calendar, will be on the phone, and it'll show up on your Windows Live calendar on your computer, or vice versa. If you put it on the computer, it'll show up on your phone. It's a really nice feature. So that way you can't forget it, and you will get a notification 15 minutes prior to your appointment to let you know that you do have an appointment. And I think you can change how soon it notifies you. If you want an hour before, you can set it an hour before. I think I've got it set for 15 minutes, but you can set it for like, because if your doctor's, let's say your doctor's a half hour away from your house, you're definitely going to want to set it like an hour in advance to remind you have an, let's say your appointment's at 10 o'clock in the morning, right? And you're going to see the doctor. You'll want that notification to go off at 9 o'clock. So you're going to want to set it to remind you an hour in advance. So that way it'll remind you. So it's really cool. So the calendar's really nice. And these are my photos. Now, this is where, if you have a Windows, when you get your Windows Live account, when you take pictures with this phone, they automatically get uploaded to SkyDrive. SkyDrive is an online cloud storage for your pictures. And you can put music on it that you can go onto your SkyDrive online and you can listen to music right on your computer, right off the SkyDrive. So it's really nice. And if you see what says camera roll, all right, that is your actual SkyDrive. If I go in here, see these are pictures that I've taken. And this is one you saw this. I took this yesterday. Oh, no, that's not yesterday. I think I deleted that one. Okay, let me go ahead and take a picture with the phone, and I will show you. I'll take a picture with the camera. And then I'll show you this. Let me turn my camera on. Okay. And I'm going to show you something, too, with this. Another feature that's really cool. I just took another picture. Okay, well, All right. Let me just, I'm going to delete this photo that it just took. Okay. Just delete that. Okay, now here's the picture I just took right here. Okay, now I just took this picture with the camera, right? Now, if you want to put this on Facebook, simple. Click the three little dots right here. See what it says share on Facebook? Or you want to share? If you want to share it somewhere else, you can come in, you got messaging, you got Hotmail, Hotmail 2, Hotmail 3, Yahoo Mail, there's Facebook, Message Toaster, which is an app that I have that's messaging with somebody, SkyDrive, Twitter, WhatsApp, WordPress. I can send this stuff right to you, but I'm going to go here and let me come back. Share on Facebook. Okay, here we go. This is the photo that I just took. You can see it's a picture of my desktop monitor. And I'm not going to put a caption with it. You'll see it online, Cindy. That's the one I took. Just go ahead and actually, I'll go ahead and put a caption. Just took photo in my Windows. Make sure that I did spell Windows right. I have to make sure because it's hard for me to see right now. Yeah, I didn't. Okay. I didn't get the O, I got the I. Okay. Okay, Windows. Phone. Okay, now I'll go over here. And 7.8. Okay, here we go. And then I'll put for Cindy P. Okay, there we go. I have to specify the last initial because I don't want to get anybody else confused thinking they're getting the phone because somebody else did want it, but you were the first, so okay, now I'm going to go ahead and send that. And right now it should be on its way. Yeah, it's on its way. There it goes. Just sent it to Facebook. I didn't have to go to my camera app or anything. I don't have a camera app, because I'll show you why. But this just sent that photo to Facebook. So, Cindy, you will see that photo on Facebook. Go to my timeline, and you'll find the photo, and you'll see how it came out decent for a quick photo. All right, I want to show you something. This is exclusive to a Windows phone. Nobody else had. Well, actually, yes, I should not say that. BlackBerry, if any of you remember having a BlackBerry or still have one, God forbid, they're kind of like dinosaur age. They are making a phone like this with a touch screen, fully touch, with no more keys on there or anything. I do have one here. Let me just show you. I have an old Verizon BlackBerry 9650. Yeah, who remembers this? I use it for a clock on my desktop charger, which makes it stand up, and I can see the time. It makes nice big numbers, so it's all it is, a clock. But if you look right here, see this button? That's a camera button on the side of this phone. But to take it, you held it like this, and you snapped it standing upright. Well, with the Windows phone, it doesn't do that. It has a dedicated camera button. So right now, this is the only phone that has a dedicated camera button, besides the little BlackBerry. I don't know if the new BlackBerry's got one or not. But as I showed you before, the camera lens is on the back, and you can see it's at the top of the phone. Let me turn on my light here and see if I can get this to light up a little bit. Okay. Now see, there's the camera button. Hey, I actually see the phone a little better too. Okay. See this button right here on top? This is the dedicated camera button. Now, from the watch this with the phone, okay, with the phone turned off, right? The phone's completely off. You know, it's in standby mode. So the screen's black. Let's say you're walking down the street and you see something that you want to catch really quick. Now with an iPhone or a Droid, if you want to catch that picture, you have to turn the phone on, get the phone to come on, then you have to find your camera app, tap it, and then tap it again to take your picture. This is exclusive to Windows Phone. Nobody else has this. This dedicated camera button right here, watch this. Hold that camera button down. Look at that. It turned the camera right on. I just snapped a picture. 2 seconds. And if I want to send it to Facebook, Okay. Well, all right. I want to send that picture I just took to Facebook. Check this out. Cindy, go check this. This was just a quick photo that I took. I'm not going to put a caption with it. You'll see it on my timeline above the one that I just posted a minute ago. And that photo, it's gone. You cannot, if I did this a little quicker, if I was, you know, not so close to all the stuff on my desk, if I was standing up and I wanted to take a quick photo, I could do that even quicker. And that's what you'll see a lot of times when you go to YouTube and watch those smoked by a Windows phone. You'll find Ben that works for Microsoft for the Windows Phone division. He's the one that does those videos. And he goes against anybody's phone and he uploads a picture right to Facebook faster than any phone. Because you cannot navigate your hands fast enough to hit that camera button. You just, well, I'll do it again. Lock screen, standby mode, hold it down, comes on, snap the photo, and then bring your photo back, go to share on Facebook. Go check for this one too, Cindy. You'll see this one again. This is the second one. I'm just waiting for it to send. It went, gone. It's already on Facebook. So, that's an exclusive feature to Windows Phone only. It's the dedicated camera button. So I'm telling you, this is a really nice phone. You're going to love this phone when you get it. And I'm going to show you a few more things, but I'll go down here. I showed you these are live tiles, which I told you. And there's all kinds of apps. You're going to love all the apps you'll find in the marketplace. Okay, this right here says marketplace. This is where you download all your apps from. If you come into here, you've got HTC apps, games, music, and podcasts, so you can get music. Now, we do have a Zoom subscription for the Zoom Pass. It's $9.99 a month, and you can download unlimited music, or you don't have to take the monthly subscription. You can just purchase songs directly from the marketplace. For between 79 cents and $1.10, I think. So they're really reasonably priced. So you can download them directly right to the phone, as well as you can do it from the software on the computer, but you're better off doing it from the phone, because then you can buy it directly right from your account with the phone. If you do it on the computer, they're going to want you to buy Microsoft points, and the least amount you can buy is 400 for like $5. So you're better off doing it from the phone. That way you can buy, if it allows it, you can buy one track individually. And that's a lot better than having to buy the 400 points. And right here is the Zoom software. So we see Kenny Chesney right here. And it actually says music videos. That's the Zoom player that's built into this phone. And here it is. You have music, videos, podcast, radio, marketplace. If I go to music, here's all the music. There's all my artists. I can scroll over, here's all the albums by those artists, or I can go to songs. If you click shuffle all, it'll shuffle through all the songs randomly that are in this phone. So it's really nice. Then you have playlists. I have two playlists. There's also genres. You can look it up by genre. If you have different types, I really got country in here. I do a little bit of rock, but it's mostly all country, bluegrass. So here's all the artists. And I have quite a bit of music in here. It's got 16 gigabytes of storage total for the full phone. That includes the operating system and the apps. The apps don't use a lot and don't take up much for space when you download an app. It's the music and the videos that will take up space. This is pretty full. I've only got like 3 gigs left, I think. And I can take stuff out to make room to bring it back up again. I normally have around 5 to 6 gigabytes in it. So it's not too bad. If you download one song, it's not going to start filling it too quick. It'll barely move, so it's not bad. So that's the player itself, and I'll show you. I'll go ahead and let me find something here that I might be interested in. I'll look under music. Let's see. I'll go to Marketplace. Okay, I'm going to purchase a track. Just so I can show you. All right. right, let me find something that's here that I'd be interested in. Because I am in the country, so... okay, all music. Let me go here. Okay, I'm going to do genre because I want to go to country. Because that's more of my thing is country. What am I looking for? Oh, right here. Yeah, if, you know, I look a little hotter, it might jump out right in front of me. Okay, let me see. Okay, this is... okay, you can sample songs too, so if you want to, like, hey, I'm going to go in here. Okay, and this is Easton Corbin. I already have some of his music. But if you want to try a song to see if it's what you're looking for, you can hit the play button right on the side. Now watch. It's going to actually go into it. And if you wait a minute, this is the actual player that's up now. And if you can see, forward, backwards on the tracks. See? Now it's playing that track. And we'll play it all the way through. Always running like I'm racing, world keeps spinning. So you can check it out to see if it's a song that you want. Okay, let me go down a little further and see. Find somebody else, something that I don't have. Okay, here's Kix Brooks. He's got a new album out. Let's try this first song, see if it's something I'd be interested in. And I'll show you. So it's going to play this song. It'll play it entirely for, it's not a clip. You can listen to the whole thing. You can stream music with this thing, so it's really nice. Okay, the name of the song is New to This Town. I think I have this. I'm going to go ahead and get it. It'll tell me if I have it. Let me pause it. Okay. Okay, it says download, so I don't have it. Okay. So you can either download it, because I have a subscription. That's why I can download it. But see right here, it says purchase available. So I can purchase the song. So I'm going to go ahead and it's verifying it. See the dots? Now, when you see those dots going across, that's the phone doing whatever you've done. Like if you're going into a website, or if you're checking emails, or if you're posting to Facebook, those red dots will go across the screen. Okay. Okay, down the bottom here, you see where it says buy. So I'm going to go ahead and buy that track. And now it's purchasing. And then when it's done purchasing, it's going to download the track for me. And now that'll be on my phone. And if I connect my phone to my computer, I can transfer it over to the computer. Okay, so now you can see it right here. I can actually go in here, and now it's showing the download status. See, it's a little red line going across. Okay, so that's actually purchasing the track. I just bought that track. I didn't see the price. I didn't pay attention. It might have been 79 cents, 99 cents. I don't know. It's cool. Doesn't matter to me. So now I just purchased that track, and it charged it right to my credit card that I have stored on Microsoft's account page. And when you do get your Windows Live account, Cindy, you're going to want to go to windowslive.com, and it's going to ask you to set up an Xbox Live account. You got to do that because that's what runs through this phone. So when you purchase stuff like apps, if you buy any games or if you do buy any music, it purchases it through the Xbox Music service, because that's what it's going to, is Xbox Music is what's going to be on the new Windows Phone 8 as well as Windows 8. They're doing away with the Zune, and it's going to be Xbox Music. Okay, so here we go. Now the download's complete, so there's nothing else in the downloads. So now if you see, look right here, it says in collection. So now it shows that I purchased that song, and now it's in collection. So when I hit play, it comes up instantly, because now I own the track, and it's here. Same thing if I download it, it'll stop playing instantly, because now it's not trying to stream... pull the information over the phone to play it. Now it's on the phone, it'll play instantly. So there we go. So I just purchased that track. So I wanted to show you that. That's the Zune software. And you will purchase... the best way is do it right from the phone. So here's all my apps. I showed you the Zune player. And these are all apps that I put in. I don't know if you have a printer, and I don't know if HP has one or not. But I have a Brother printer. If you see this app right here, this is for my printer. I can print photos from this. I can scan on something from the scanner bed onto my phone, as well as I can I can print pictures right directly from the camera. If I print from camera, then I can snap a picture, and then I can print it right to the the printer right from here. So watch, I'll snap the picture. Okay, now watch this. Accept. Okay. There we go. And now what I want to do is, okay, it's showing me my printer. So now I want to print. Now it's sending it right over to my printer. And then we look at the photo. It says NXT in the photo. That's my screen for my computer that shows my temps inside as well as my fan speeds. Okay. Cannot connect. It's not connecting right now. Not a big deal. I'll try it one more time. If it don't connect, I'll deal with that later. It's just an issue. We'll see. See, it's going. It's just printing. Maybe it went this time. Nope. Okay. Well, that's okay. That's fine. But anyways, it'll send it to the printer. I just wanted to show you that. You don't have to see it, but it does work. So these are all my apps. This is an app I want to show you real quick. It's called a barcode scanner. Now, if you find you've seen these codes before, if you find this one right here, you see this one that it looks really funky. You'll see a lot of places like if you go out to eat, a lot of restaurants have these on a thing sitting on the table. If you take your phone and scan that barcode and then click on the information button, it'll take you right to their website where you can check the restaurant out. There's different types of UPC symbols that you can scan with this phone, and it'll give you information about that particular product. It'll take you right to their website, so it's really cool. So you can get a barcode, and I'll show you, if you want that app, it's free, and I can show you where to go. Actually, I think I did pay for it, but there was a trial version, but if you want to buy it, it wasn't much. I think it was like $1.99. It was cheap. So these are all my apps. I do have a Netflix app. If I want to watch movies, I have a Netflix account. I can go to Netflix, and I can go watch movies right on this phone. So if I'm at a doctor's appointment and I want to watch a movie, and if I have my Bluetooth headphones on that I have for this, I could actually sit there and watch a movie while I'm waiting. It's fantastic, I'm telling you. I'll just let it open so you can see, get into Netflix. It's great. I watch Netflix on my computer, on my TVs. My TVs have got wireless in them, so I can watch it on that. But see, here's all my recent stuff that I've watched. Beverly Hills Cop 3, K-9000, Beverly Hills Cop 2. It's got genres. You can search on the genres. There's TV shows, action, adventure, all that good stuff. There's Instant Queue. The Instant Queue is where you can put stuff that you want to watch again down the road. You can just fill it up. I've got Dennis the Menace. I love the original old black and white to Dennis the Menace. Andy Griffith, my favorite show of all time. I'll never end up not liking that. So all the stuff is here. It's just unbelievable what you can do with Netflix. You can watch that right on the phone. So you can add even websites you can bring out to this main part of the start screen. If you scroll to the left, this is everything that's in this phone. This is all your apps. Everything that's in it is right here. These are all your apps. Now, if you want to bring an app out to the start screen, watch. If I hold my finger down on this, see, now you see pin to start, rate and review, uninstall. If I click pin to start, now watch. Now I just put Adobe Reader right here on the front screen. If I want to move it, I hold it down. Now see, it shows like a little pin. It's unpinned right now. I can take this and I can move it right up to the spot. I want to put it right here. I tap. Now I just move that up. So you can move all these live tiles. All these tiles on the front, you can move them around. Now Windows Phone 8 has created some really nice live tiles. See the photos, the calendar, and also the HTC app. Those are what's known as a large tile. These other ones are medium. These are the only two size tiles that's available on this phone, on a Windows Phone 7. The new Windows Phone 8, you can change the size of the tile. You can even, if the developer allows it, which Microsoft does with all of their apps, you can change it between a large, a medium, or a small. So you can fit a lot of small tiles right on the screen. Now this one only allows certain ones, and it's mainly the HTC and the Microsoft apps. If they develop it in a medium or a large, those are the only two. The other developers, I don't think people, third-party apps, I don't think they can develop a large one. Maybe they can, I don't know. I've never run across one yet, but it's possible. But you can move all these tiles around. Just click it, hold it, it unpins it, and you can put that tile anywhere you want. So I have all my contacts right up here at the top of the screen so that I can access them. So I wanted to show you that. The new Windows Phone 8, I'm going to take like a big tile and put it on top, another big one below it, and I'm going to put all my people's contacts right up here. I'll have a big one here, a big one down the bottom, and I'll make all my people's contacts really small so they're in between, and they'll be right there where I can see them, and they're live tiles just like you see, so it's really nice. So this is everything that's in this phone, and the one that I did add to the front, which is I keep it right here, not that far down, my settings. This is the settings to change things on the phone. Like one thing, if you want to change your theme, look at this. Right now I've got it on what's called Verizon. If I change it to Magenta, watch this. You can customize this phone a little bit. Not as well as the Windows Phone 8s, but you can customize it. Now look at the colors of my tiles. See how they've gone to a magenta or kind of a purplish color? That all happened from me changing the color of the theme. Now watch. Now, if the developer allows it, like you saw, there was an app that was still red. Okay. Let's change it. Oh, let's go. Cindy, you're a woman. Let's go. I know you must like pink. Let's make my apps pink. Now look at this. Now most of my tiles have all turned pink. See, my Bank of America app's still red. The Message Toaster's still blue. So it's up to the developer if they allow the color of the tile to be changed or not. A lot of them don't. They've got it in a specific color because they want it that color for a reason. So it's really cool. So you can do that. So there's a lot in here. And another thing I'll show you real quick. You just change this back to my Verizon red because that's the color. My favorite color is red and orange. So, all right, let me go back into the settings. I could have just backed up. It's right here. Email and accounts. This is where you're going to add emails. I don't know if this will work with an AOL account or not. You'll have to try it and see. But here's all my email addresses, Windows Live, Windows Live 2, Windows Live 3, my Twitter, my Facebook, my Yahoo Mail, and my LinkedIn. These are all where you have to sign in with those accounts in order for them to work on the start screen. So like with Facebook, whatever your password is to get into your Facebook account, you have to have sign in under the settings, sign in the email and accounts in order to click on Facebook to get into Facebook. I think it actually, you sign in right here, I think. You do it right with Facebook. The sign-in page will come up, put in your email address, your password, and when you go back to that settings page where it says email and accounts, it'll automatically show up over there. And if you need to change it, then you can go in there and you can change the password. If you change it on Facebook, you have to change it in the phone, or else you will not get notifications. Like, see, I've got notifications right here. Pull this down a little bit so you can see it. See, it's showing notifications. Or if I scroll over, there's notifications here, and it tells me what notifications I have. So it's really cool. It's a nice show. You'll see when you get to the Facebook app. It's a really nice app. I do have a second one that I bought, and it's not available anymore, so I keep it. I'm also on Google Plus. If you guys want to hit me up on Twitter, I'm on Twitter. I'm on Twitter at Cowboy. I'm at Cowboy6201. That's my Twitter handle. Just go hit me up. Follow me. I'll follow you back. And I'm on YouTube. I have two YouTube accounts. My normal YouTube account that I use for all my videos, for when I do my bike rides and videos that I upload, music videos and stuff that I do. It's Cowboy6201. So just go to YouTube and look me up at Cowboy6201. Or if you want to see my Around the Corner show, go over to YouTube and sign in with Mr. Cowboy 620. That's Mr. Cowboy 620, and that'll take you over to my YouTube account for my Around the Corner show. You can find me over there at those two places. I'm also on LinkedIn. You can just look me up as Glenn Weaver, and you can connect with me on LinkedIn, on Google Plus. If you want to join my circle, just look me up under Glenn Weaver, and you'll find me there. But like I said, if you want to hit me up on Twitter, if you've got a Twitter account, I'm at Cowboy6201. That's my Twitter handle. So pretty much, I guess that's about it with this phone. I've showed you a lot with this phone, so you're going to love this phone when you get it, Cindy. I don't know. I'll hit up my friend Jacob, and I'll kind of try to get an idea when they're going to get the phones. He said they usually know 2 days after they announce the new phones, he knows what's coming. So I'll find out from him, see if I can get a timeline of when this month. It may not be to what Microsoft originally said, November 2nd. That'll be the latest, so I'll find out when I can get my new phones, and then I'll be showing that off when I get it in my hands. But Jerry, you're going to want one of these phones once you see the one Cindy's got. If you guys are older for an upgrade at all, go get one of these phones. You can get it cheap. Because when the Windows Phone 8 comes out, they'll drop the price of this phone. Or if they've got to recertify, grab a recertified. They're fine. Verizon backs it up for a whole year. It'll be just like you get a new phone. They'll warranty it for a year. Take the insurance for, $6.99 a month. And if you drop it in the ocean, or if you run it over your car, or if either you guys fall on the phone and break it, they'll send you a replacement. It's refurbished, but hey, it works. So, all right, well, I guess that's it. I've showed you the phone. You're going to get it soon. I'll let you know as soon as it'll be coming. And if you want, Cindy, I know you said your mother's right down the road from me at Bayview Campground. If you just want to come down to my house and pick it up, that's fine with me. I'm 2 minutes away from Bayview Campground. So if you just want to come right to my house, you and Jerry can take a day and come down. It's fine. I'm also up in New Bedford, Fall River a lot because my mother-in-law lives in Fall River in Riverview Towers, and my brother-in-law, Michelle's brother Steve, lives in New Bedford. Right now he's living over on... I forget the name of the street now. I have to think. It'll come to me. But anyways, yeah, he's over in New Bedford. He's over near Dartmouth. He's not that far from... He's right next to Buttonwood Park, almost. There's the phone. The HTC Trophy from Verizon. 3G network. And I'm sure you have 3G is what you got, so you'll have to take a data plan to go with this. But, so there you go. There's your new phone. It's less than a year old. It won't be this particular one. But if this one does become available, I'll be giving this particular phone away. It's up to my stepson. He says he wants one of our phones. And he owes a big $700 phone bill from Verizon because we were camping in Maine. And he actually was checking emails, and he don't have data to do that. He only had whatever he had, maybe none, I don't know. He does text. He does do a lot of texting, but he checked emails, and he racked up a $700 phone bill, which he didn't know. If he had talked to me, I would have told him, no, don't do that. You're gonna use up your data, and you'll have a huge phone bill. So he's disabled. He's got a financial advisor up in Alaska, so that's where he's living. And we're trying to get it switched to somebody down here. So they're going to try and make payments with Verizon. The woman said something about, we can do a payment arrangement. So I don't know what's going to happen. If he doesn't get the phone, then this phone's going to be available and up for grabs. But it's all up to him if he gets it or not. I got a feeling his account's going to get shut off and he won't have a phone. So if it does, then this phone's going to be available. And I will post on Facebook that this phone will be available. So, all right, that's it for me. I guess I'm out of here. I'll catch you guys on Facebook. I'll be on. Michelle won't get out of work till 7 tonight. Which, oh boy, it's that late already. 6:27? God, she'll be home in a half hour. She'll be leaving in a half hour. Jeez, where'd time go? All right, well, here it is. I'll show you the back. One more time, HTC. So there it is. That's the phone you'll be getting, Cindy. And, oh, I'll put it in this case. It's my around-the-corner case. Well, it's not this phone you'll be getting. You'll be getting my wife's phone, actually, but hers is the newer of the two. Mine will be a year old November 1st, but it still works great. There's not a scratch on it. I keep it covered with this protector. I keep a screen protector on it. And so this is the one of the neoprene covers that you'll be getting. I have some brand new ones, so you'll be getting a brand new one in the package. And I keep it right in this cover, so that way it stays protected and the phone doesn't get... So I'll give you one of these. I'll give you a couple of these covers. So there it is. HTC Trophy from Verizon. Cindy, good luck. You'll love it, I'm telling you. So good for you, Cindy. I'm glad you got it. You were the first one. If you look at the... If you go back to that page, you'll see, besides my friend Pam, you were right below her, and Pam didn't want it. Pam wasn't interested. She just thought that was really sweet that I did that. So there you go. That's it. All right, I'm out of here, you guys. See ya.